fresh. It began in Soho, London. Me and Peter Olbeck, the man from Zumtopia, talking about where our love for films comes. We both the same generation, and when we were in the 60s and 70s and children, we had only one television channel in Denmark. You can't imagine that as Americans, but that was one channel.
We only had four.
Yeah, okay,
then,
we had one. Yeah. And on Saturdays, there was only one kind of movie, Westerns. So that's, you know, your first love. Your first love of the media, the first strong emotional reaction comes from there. And we were talking about that. We were talking because I've always kind of continued. I just love Western. I love John Ford. So, I don't know if Peter had too much Barolo or whatever happened, but he said, Kristian, I think you should do a Western. And that was like quite a mad thing. But of course, me being a Western lover, I said, yes.
So did you grow up on color Westerns, or they were all in black and white when you were watching them today?
Well, we didn't. First of all, Danish television didn't screen anything in color when I was a child. Secondly, so we didn't have a color television. So I much later realized that, for instance, Her Yellow Ribbon, that was actually in colors, or The Searchers were in colors. I saw them black and white, but of course some of them were in black, like Fort Apache or
right.
or Stagecoach or My Darling Clementine, which are some of my favorites.
Mm-hmm.
Specifically My Darling Clementine, or I would say Man Who Shot Liberty Valance, The Searchers. Those are films I never get out of my head.
Well, the color scheme you chose though for this movie is kind of like the early three strip process, but
yeah.
a, like, you know, hyperactive version of
yeah.
it.
Yeah, yeah.
Was that a decision of an homage to the period, or was that just what
no,
you were drawn to?
It was. I felt I wanted the genre, the Western genre, is a colorful genre in its narration.
Mm-hmm.
So I felt I want to do a very colorful film. To bring, you know, that kind of striking colors into it, and of course there's different westerns as well. Like
mm-hmm.
Robert Altman did a fantastic western called McCabe and Miss Miller, which is very realistic.
Yeah.
But that was not the kind of western I was doing. I tried to work more like in the more mythical kind of western.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted that kind of, you know, über life or whatever you call it. That was kind of an important part of it.
So did you ramp it up in post, or was it, how much of this was in camera, color wise?
It was a mixture. I spent a lot of time on color schemes and stuff like that in production.
Mm-hmm.
These are things that matters to me, you know. So and then we enhanced that in post.
And it was, how much of it was shot on location?
Everything
all
was shot.
Of it was
yeah,
all
yeah.
of it was.
Yeah. yeah. It's actually even the interiors.
Mm-hmm.
We built them. We didn't shoot in studio. We built the interiors almost like a location, so that you are inside a house when you're actually. I think that's something that really helps the actors.